Let's do an error analysis for our left and right rectangle sum approximating methods for our definite integral. So we use this function that we've seen before, 4 over x. We're going to integrate it from 1 to 5. The answer that we get when you integrate is this answer here, 6.437752, and that's rounded off. All right, so I went in a program called MathCAD, and I made up this chart for n sizes of 5. Your left sum is 7.9 something. Your right sum is this. The error of the left is the difference between this number and the actual true value. So when you subtract these two right here, and take the absolute value, you get this number here. So that's the error difference between the left approximating method when you're using 5 subintervals. That's your error. And the right rectangle sum error is this. And then I finish up this table by jumping factors of 10. So there's factors of 10. So this is 5, 50, 500, 5,000, and 50,000. And as you can see, following the left, your numbers are getting closer and closer and closer to the true value, but they're still not there, even for 50,000 n. And the right starts off as an underestimate. It's always going to be under, because of this particular function was monotonic decreasing. So it's still not there. Even with 50,000 subintervals, you're still not there. Now let's look at the error. The error from here to here looks like about 10 times less. And look at the decimal point as it's moving. It's 0.13 here. And now it's 0.013 if you round it off. And now it's 0.0013 if you round it off. Now it's 0.00013. So every time the error is decreasing by approximately a factor of 10, it's going down by a factor of 10 as we increase the n size by a factor of 10. And the same thing happens with the right rectangle sums. After you get going here, when you're at 50, you can see that this is 0.126, this is 0.0128, rounds off, 0.00128, 0.000128. So every time you're going down by a factor of 10 when you're increasing your n size by a factor of 10. So the final analysis, as n increases by a factor of 10, the error decreases by a factor of 10. So in other words, we get a resulting increase in accuracy equal to the processing work we put in. So maybe that's good and maybe that's bad. It looks a little slow, because by the time you get to 50,000 n, you expect your approximating method to be pretty good, and we're pretty good. We got the three places here, and then we diverge in the last three places, so we're really not there yet. But well, at least we see that the left and right rectangle sum method is legitimate, approximating method, but we'll see later that it's not that good compared to some of the other methods.